Hello everybody, welcome to the second Ultimate Team game. Alright, here we go. Let's freaking do this. Okay, looks fair. Alright, let's go. Who's getting the ball? Me? Alright. Even though I think it has more of a strategic effect to get it at halftime, but oh well. Try to score. If I don't score, that's gonna be kind of bad. So let's see here. Come on. Ugh. Darn it.
One tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
Fellas like to talk about the defensive levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
On second down, here's Brady.
Darn it. That sucked. Dang it. That's what I get when I stare at somebody before the play goes.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. Throwing is Brady on 3rd down. It's brought in by
Nice.
And he will have a 1st down.
All right. Good stuff.
13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Throughout his career, Tom Brady has made a living with a quick pass, hasn't he? How about that one? A little slant inside, and I think his arm's gotten stronger throughout his career, too.
Yeah. You can just see one of many examples of why he's made more trips to the Super Bowl than any other quarterback.
Footwork, intelligence, competitiveness, that's Tom Brady in a nutshell.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Now Brady. On the left side, a catch by Wade. A good pickup.
All right. All righty.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people.
Let's see here.
Then he'll give it here to his
right. Oh!
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on the first down.
You know, pick my play too quickly.
When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Brady to throw on 2nd down. To the sideline and oh, a nice catch there.
Dang it. Keep doing that.
2 yards to go here on 3rd down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making
ha! Go, go, go! Yeah!
And he will have the first before he's brought down.
Beautiful.
A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
And that's the way to get things started the first time you touch the football on the road. And you have to believe, all week long, all they've talked about is, okay, going into a hostile environment, we're the visiting team.
Dang it.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's 2nd down.
God dang it, Michael Crabtree. God dang it, what the freak? That sucked. Yeah, I wonder what he's doing.
He was trying to get it to Michael Crabtree there.
All right.
Bring up a 3rd and 11 situation. This now play number 9 on the opening drive, but it's 3rd and long. Brady gonna throw.
He's got a man. Oh, yes.
down at the 6.
And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
First and goal. Defense with their backs against the...
Nice.
He is in.
Yeah.
Touchdown, New England. A great play there. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots...
Wow.
...right down the field and score on the opening drive.
Darn it, I swear, I hate the new kicking so much. Dang it, that's gonna screw me up, too.
Now after the touchdown,
dude, I can never do that.
This'll be taken in at
the one. Wow, that sucks.
It's a 5-receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. Now Newton on first down. Surveying the field. And gets this one to Michael Crabtree.
Darn it.
And he's brought down after a good game. It's a gain of 24 that time. And it's good enough for a Tennessee first down. They'll run it now out of the gun.
There we go.
Going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll take us to the end of the first quarter.
Sorry. Now, what's he doing? Oh, come on, man. Let's go. Jeez.
The game can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
And they'll run it here. Take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. Just a couple on the ground there, and that's going to bring up 3rd and about 6.
And that's why you see a lot of teams that like to play 4-3 defense, especially against...
All right, let's see.
Really well, because you count on your defensive front, the tackles and the ends, to eat up the blocking in the offensive line and keep that guy in the middle clean so he can roam through the football and make a tackle. In this case, he introduced himself and said, hello.
Oh, come on. Get out of here.
Throwing right, and that's complete. Give him 8 yards on the play, and they pick up the first.
Look like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
To throw is new.
Aha, almost a fumble.
Incomplete. Michael
Darn it.
The intended receiver, and it'll be 2nd and 10.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with 3rd and still 7 yards to go.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Darn it!
Complete. It's a 10-yard pickup, but it moves the chains. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it, we can throw it well, with a whole lot of confidence.
Now they go screen, it's complete. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll make it 2nd down. Completed pass play, now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. So a pause here for us as well, time to pay some bills. Back to Tennessee after this. On 2nd down, here's Newton.
Darn it!
We often with Cam Newton talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can lock it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his.
Dang it!
Titans touchdown. Tyler Varga, a 3-yard touchdown run. And his guys are an extra point away now.
Oh, okay. Missed it too. Nice. There we go, that worked.
Football overall, add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts.
Ah.
If they're smart, they do.
And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So the Patriots coming out now. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan. And thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they
Darn
can
it.
Get back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Here's Brady to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. And quickly, they get to the line.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield.
Nice! Freaking fullback doing plays.
Tommy Bohannon, 60 yards. And the Pats able to cash in for six. And he wasn't blocking or running it there. They tossed it to him.
You remember the good old days when the 49ers were riding roughshod in the league? They use their fullback and pass plays all the time. Roger Craig, Tom Raffman, those guys were terrific at running these types of plays.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now Newton.
Oh!
Complete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
So third and two, and I count six defensive backs out there. Now it's Newton. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. A gain of 13 and also a first down.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah. Cam fighting. He lost
Darn it.
The ball. It's out. Timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the offense avoids disaster, keeps possession. Now it's second down. Here's Newton now on second down.
Darn it!
23 yards on the play. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. On first and 10, Newton.
Oh, come on. He really caught that.
26 yards on the pickup there. And the Titans are going to have a first and goal. And there they went crossing route against the zone defense. What do you think of that?
It takes real coordination between the passer and the receiver because you
can nice.
Those zones and where the open spots are and be on the same page with the guy throwing the football. Because sometimes you're throwing it in front of the zone, sometimes you're throwing it between the zones, sometimes the receiver's going to just kind of find a spot and what we call sit down and present himself to the quarterback and throw it there. It's a tough read, but when they're in sync, it's really effective.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get it.
Darn it.
35, right at the 34 here. The gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and we'll still get the first down. They love being physical.
A right side catch by Clamp. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Toss.
Nice.
He's gonna lose yardage here. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
Oftentimes when you're not winning at the point of attack for an offensive line, maybe they're getting out physical, spread things out a little bit, make it more of a one-on-one blocking scheme. Then you don't have to win it physically, you just have to win it by position. That may open things up for your running back.
Darn it, I wish you kind of would have got tackled there.
So many components go into a well-executed screen pass. You've got to sell. Offensive line's got to sell like they've missed blocks, and then they move out, and they're out in front of the running back. He's got to sell that he's trying to block, and then he slips out into the route. The quarterback has to sell that maybe he's trying to throw it downfield. Instead, he slips it off to a running back, and when you get it...
That sucks.
You have to catch the ball, and that didn't happen on that play.
They give him 17 yards that time, as that'll move the chains. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body, it's hard to get him down, even if you get a clear shot on him. Plus, he moves it a lot faster than what people think. And boy, does he have fun playing the game of football.
The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. To throw on second down is new.
Oh.
Incomplete, almost intercepted. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Another pistol look here. Third and long, it's Newton.
Nice.
Incomplete, took a shot, couldn't connect. Offense out to go for it on fourth. On fourth down.
Oh, ho, ho. Oh, ho, ho. Oh.
Naturally, we're going to say it's a poor pass, but the defensive guys say it was just a great play by them. They broke on the football, picked it off, and gave some momentum to their team.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Old school defensive tackle play dictates just stood up and dance with the guy in front of you. If a guy came near, tackle him. New school.
Come on! Ugh. Nice. First down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Fresh set of downs here. Throwing on first down is Brady. And unable to connect on the line. Darn it.
Have the lead. They also have the football. They come out here in the eye. And he'll give it here to his running back.
Oh! Yeah! Nice!
Not only gets him a nice chunk of yardage, but takes the clock under 4 minutes. And now they're going to play situational football. How many timeouts does the opposition have left? How many runs do they need to call to make sure they bleed out those timeouts? But even more importantly, mentally right now, they hold the advantage. They probably have them at the verge of breaking. And what they want to do...
Go, go, go! Ugh!
Push his way up to about the 14. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Time running out here on the play clock. On second down, here's Brady.
Oh, man.
There, a nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up 3rd down.
And there's a good opportunity to just want to ride there, a drop pass. I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7. The play clock's running down. From the gun on 3rd down, Brady.
Yeah!
Caught at the 4. And he will have the first.
Nice!
Down at the 3.
And that pickup of a 1st down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
Yep. Just let this clock run out.
Play clock winding down. Now a handoff here to his
boom.
And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. A great effort there. His 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Patriots add on to their lead. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away.
All right, now we just gotta stop them, and we got this.
And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. Looked like they had something going last drive, then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's get back to what you were doing well before.
Oh, picked off, baby.
And that should do it. A great read, and it's picked off. And they will
take over possession of the football at their 42-yard line. Out comes the New England.
Didn't quit.
In the end zone last time, they'll be looking to do that.
Went some points. Still get points even though you lose.
Punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense,
push me out.
Get to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
Darn it.
Let's see if they dial it up this drive. Time for a break. We'll come back and see this one out after this. They come up at an offset eye. Brady now to throw. He's just going to dump. To the races down the right side.
Boom. That fullback's killing it.
Patriots add six to their lead.
Well, we can clearly see this guy's been cooled down.
The extra point. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21 points. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that. The coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game.
Now, that's what I did. I changed from zone to man.
And pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
And he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him. And he turns it into a nice game.
Now Newton. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Kareem Martin in there to get him for a loss of five.
All right, dang it.
Here's Newton now on second down. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. Call it a gain of 13 yards on the play. And just like that, it's third down. Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy on the flat.
Man, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progression, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception.
Oh. Darn it. Got burned, eh?
Something maybe positive to look at on film. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. So time definitely not in their favor. Down two scores, but they'll try the onside kick. And the Patriots are going to recover, and that should just about assure victory. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Toe to the leather on that one. Their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is, and really a lot of the time they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
And it's in. All right. Still time left, though. 2 seconds remaining now in the fourth quarter.
We'll go for one long play.
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, six DBs. And down he goes.
Darn it.
They sack it back across.
Oh, well. Oh, well. We won the game anyways.
So you win the game. Not only do you get the W in the left-hand column, you get some momentum for the coming week.
Now when you go into the week and you're telling the guys what mistakes have to be corrected, what we have to do to
nicely
win.
Nicely done.
Full attention. They're excited. They're happy. And they know if they can build that momentum, they can ultimately achieve all their goals.